Mr. Prabhu, asking to the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Ministry of Electronics. So this is a lab, fuel weapons function lab, and which turbines we are going to be with turbines. So here this turbine is a Francis turbine. So turbines we classify into impulse and reaction turbines. So impulse turbines is turbine where at the input only kinetic energy will be available. But whereas in case of reaction turbines, both kinetic energy as well as weather energy. So this weather energy also gets converted into kinetic energy. So this Francis turbine, so depending upon the selection of the turbine, so if you want to select any turbine, so depending upon the head available. So head available means, so in the actual practice on the reservoirs, the head available in terms of meters of water. So this Francis turbine is a medium head turbine. So that means it utilizes between 60 meters of water. 250 meters of water. So then we can go for Francis turbine. And also Francis turbine is more than Francis turbine is a mixed flow turbine. So what is mixed flow turbine? So mixed flow turbine is water is entering radially and leaves axially. Radially means perpendicular to the axis of the turbine or runner of the turbine, then leaving parallel to the axis of the run out the turbine. So here we have a engine meter which is in red color, which is used to calculate the rate of flow or discharge Q. So the what is the internal energy or what is the function of the basic function of any turbine is conversion of hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. Then mechanical to electrical. So in the hydraulic energy input, hydraulic input, finally electrical input. So it is why, so input energy is OG and H. So in which, in the formula OG and H, input power equal to OG and H. O is density of the water, then G is acceleration due to gravity, Q is discharge or rate of flow. Q can be calculated by using this engine meter. That is why for the input of the turbine, there is a engine meter sticker. What is the amount of water hitting the runner vanes? So that is why discharge can be calculated by using engine meter, and which is head available. So depending upon the head available, so it is a medium head. Francis turbine is a medium head reaction turbine. So as I said, reaction turbine is at the input of the turbine, while water is hitting at the turbine vanes, there are two energies available, weather energy as well as kinetic energy. So again, this weather energy also gets converted to kinetic energy, and the kinetic energy rotates the runner of the turbine, and which will goes out, the running water goes out to the draft tube. So in the reaction turbines, the draft tube is also one of the important important part in which this draft tube is used to convert whatever the after running over this vanes fluid, this passing through the draft tube to the sump. So it carries some kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy gets converted into kinetic energy, then increasing to the sump. So the draft tube is a increasing diameter pipe, conical shape. This is conical draft tube. There are different draft tubes. So here we are using conical draft tube. So through which the water will be the pressure, the kinetic energy after running over this fluid for the runner vanes. So some kinetic energy is also available. So the kinetic energy gets converted into pressure energy and released to the sum. Right? So here the mechanical energy. So after hitting the runner vanes, are rotating and creating. So it is a mixed flow turbine. Mixed flow means water enters
on the periphery of the runner veins, radially, radially means perpendicular to the axis of the rotation of the runner, and leaves axially, parallel to the axis of the runner. So from there, while it is rotating, so this breakdown, this is actually dynamometer, this one is dynamometer, brake drum dynamometer, which is used to measure the torque. Torque can be calculated. So that hydraulic energy coming from here. So initially we should open this gate wall. Maybe we can open half, 3/4, half, 1/4, or full gate opening depending upon the head available. So generally we can keep half gate opening. So half gate opening, and depending upon the gate opening, the water is coming onto the runner veins and the runner wheel rotates. So while it is rotating, here there is a mechanical shaft which is attached to this dynamometer. So this dynamometer we can apply tensions. These are the springs, forces, spring forces. What is called force into perpendicular distance. So this is the actually here the breakdown is rotating. Some forces are attaching, forces are applying on this breakdown tangentially. So that is why tensions in the springs T1 and T2 can be noted down. So T1, T2 should be there. And breakdown radius, this is a standard brake dynamometer, breakdown radius. So radius we should know, when manufacturing this breakdown, the radius may be 2.5 centimeters in this case, right? So T1 minus T2 we can load it from the spring balance. So tensions, so that should be in kgs. So you should convert into newtons by multiplying some 10, right? Then you have T1 minus T2 into R, radius of the breakdown, gives you the torque. So what is the output power? The input power is hydraulic energy, rho g cubic, whereas the output energy is mechanical, 2 pi nt by 60, where T is the torque developed. Torque can be calculated by using a formula T1 minus T2, tensions in the springs, it may be T1, T2, difference in the tensions. And radius we know, that is standard value, multiplied by, you can obtain the torque. N is RPM. RPM can be, R speed of the breakdown can be measured by using a tachometer. So what are the instruments here? Usually here, only tachometer, apparatus required. So tachometer and stopwatch. Stopwatch is for measuring the H1, H2 in mercury meter reading, whereas tachometer is used to measure the speed, RPM of the brake drum. So tachometer pointer, we can keep it here and note down the RPM. So 2 pi MPa by 60, that is output power. Input power, rho g qh. And output power, input power using mechanical efficiency. Efficiency eta mechanical equal to 2 pi mt by 60 divided by rho g qh in output power by input power. But whereas Q can be calculated by using eventual meter. But whereas this again brake drum is connected to the generator. Right? DC generator or generator which is converts mechanical power into electrical power. So which is attached by a spring drive. Whenever this brake drum is rotating, so it is again connecting to the electrical energy. So here we can note down from this electrical voltage and current can be, we can note down from the meter readings, voltage and current we can note down. Then output power is V into I. Voltage into current gives you power, that is output. Input is same, hydraulic only, rho g qh. So output power by input power gives you the electrical efficiency. So this is how we can calculate the efficiency of the turbine. So the aim of the experiment is, Franchi turbine is to find the efficiency or to draw the characteristic curves. So we can draw the curves between speed and discharge and the speed and efficiency, like that we can draw the different curves. So the aim is to find the mechanical efficiency as well as electrical efficiency. So Francis turbine is a reaction turbine, mixed flow turbine, then it is a medium head turbine and medium specific speed turbine also. So specific speed we don't require here. The head should be available 62 to 50 meters of water. That is why it is called as a medium head turbine. And this is a mixed flow turbine, right? This is modern Francis turbine. Okay, then you can calculate H1, H2 from vg/m. So discharge can be calculated A1, A2 under square root of 2gh divided by A1 square minus A2 square, CD, where CD is coefficient of discharge. Coefficient of discharge for a particular vg/m is 0.98. A1, A2 are, A1 is area of the main pipe, A2 is area of the throat here. Actually, this is the throat where this manometric limb is connected, and the other limb is connected to the main pipe, or main pipe only here. From the main pipe, we can have A1. From the this one is A2, venturi throat. So from there, which one should be because of the pressure difference at the throat as well as the main pipe, there should be H1 and H2 should be different. Manometric limbs, left limb, right limb heights, H1, H2. So, difference of H1, H2, you can call it as X. X into S1 by S2, where S1 is manometric fluid, specific gravity of the manometric fluid, divided by S2 is specific gravity of the water, right? So, specific gravity of the heavier liquid divided by specific gravity of the lighter liquid. So, S1 by S2. From that, we can calculate Q equal to CD into A1 A2 under square root of 2GH divided by A1 square minus square root of A1 square minus A2 square. So, from that, you can calculate head as well as Q can be calculated. Then, finally, substitute in the input power. Input power is rho g credits. Output power is 220 by 60. So, output by input gives you the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is V into I. Electrical power V into I, voltage into current, voltage and current can be, we can calculate voltmeter and ammeter, we can calculate the same voltmeter here, and ammeter, both current and voltage we can note it. Then finally, output power is voltage into current divided by input power is voltage into current. Okay, thank you.
Like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.